Hi, everybody. Barbara Vey here, and I'm in Madison, Wisconsin, you know, Party Town, USA. So I took a little trip from Milwaukee, and look who I ran into, Bill Corbett. And you'll know him from, and I have to look at this because I want to make sure I say it right, Master Science Theater 3000.
No.
So it's Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Correct.
Magnificent stuff.
Well, thank you. I did not invent it. I cannot take credit for it. I just didn't wreck it.
You were right up in the, you had the front seats. You were making everybody laugh.
That's true. I was the voice of one of the two robots who were puppets, and we had a human who was less important, of course. I played Crow T Robot for a couple of years after Trace Ballou, who originated the part, left the show.
And I thought I read on Wikipedia that you did several characters, though.
Yeah, I did another. Well, I did a bunch of little, you know, one-off characters here and there, but I also played one of the villains called the Observer, who was an omniscient alien who carried his brain around in a pan, and also known colloquially as Brain Guy. I played one of the, arguably the heroes and the villains.
And okay, so heroes and villains, who was your favorite?
They were both fun. You know, I liked putting down the puppet every now and then and putting on 20 pounds of makeup.
And carrying a brain in a pan.
Nothing that beats that.
Nothing. But you have something new now. So why don't you tell us about Riff Tracks?
Riff Tracks is myself and two of my former colleagues from Mystery Science Theater, Kevin Murphy and Michael J. Nelson, who is the second host of the show and head writer there too. And we do something kind of similar, but it's we don't have puppets anymore. We're getting a little old for that. And we do humorous movie commentary for a combination of contemporary movies and so some of those old cheesy ones and old educational shorts. And on October 24th, we have a nationwide broadcast in movie theaters of Night of the Living Dead. So it'll be, you'll see the movie on screen, but we'll be kind of stacked up Brady Bunch style on the side commenting.
Well, how is that going to work? Because it's playing a bunch of different theaters. Yeah. You aren't going to be in every theater.
Yes, we are. We are magic. No.
You are. No. We are getting the inside scoop here.
No, we film it in Nashville, Tennessee. And it just simulcasts to theaters around the country, and it's live, yeah, with all the scary stuff that goes along with that.
Well, that is very exciting, because I was wondering how you were going to do that. And what's next on the horizon for you?
Well, I've been touring around with John Hodgman a little bit, which has been great fun, kind of doing stuff that I don't usually do, like singing a little bit and telling jokes to people on stage. I have a comic book coming out in, a couple of months. So that's kind of what's next.
Well, what's that called? What's your comic book called?
It's called Superpowered Revenge Christmas. And it's a, and it's sort of hopefully bringing together all of the, iconic pop culture Christmas characters together in a superhero, you know, epic.
Well, you know, we do review books on my site, so okay. We watch out. We might be going after you.
All right.
Now,
no
to close, problem. I've got a very special question for you, because being a puppeteer, have you always aspired to be like on Sesame Street?
I was nowhere near good enough to be on Sesame Street. I should be so worthy to be in the Henson world. But no, I learned on the job at Mystery Science Theater. They kind of threw me in there, and I suited up and took the puppet and learned. And Crow was kind of a complicated, sort of top-heavy puppet. I think the Muppets might have been built a little more, in a little, you know, more standard way. But that would have been an honor. We all grew up with that and loved it.
Well, thanks so much for joining us, and I'm really, really excited to see your show tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Nice spending time with you.